What is going on, guys? This is Joaquin Corrales. Welcome back to the channel. And in this video, we're going to learn about Facebook ads dark posts. Okay, I've had a whole bunch of people commenting on my other Facebook training, the one where I show you guys how to go from a beginner to a complete master. If you haven't watched that, go ahead and watch it. If you don't know how to use Facebook ads or you want to learn more about it, then that video is going to take you from an absolute beginner to a master. And I've had a lot of comments in that video asking me about Facebook dark posts, how to do it, when should you use it, and when does it make the most sense for us to do that as opposed to just creating a regular post. So before I get into that, I want to explain the difference between a Facebook dark post and a regular post. So we have two sides to it, right? We have the Facebook dark post, we're just going to put FD, and then we just have a regular post. And so what happens is that we have our Facebook page right here, right? We have the page of our online store. And when we go to this page and we just click on that little button that says post, what we're creating is a regular post that anyone could see, okay? So any post that we add to our page through the actual page is going to be a regular post that anyone could see. Now, can we run advertisement to this post? Yes, we can, right? And so what is a Facebook dark post? So what a Facebook dark post is imagine that we were able to put a post on our page that no one was able to see, right? A post that was invisible. And so there's a lot of benefits to that, because let's say you have a competitor and that competitor is spying on your store. If they come into your store and you put up a regular post that you then started running advertisement to, then they're going to be able to see what type of posts you're running ads to, what products are working, and what they're going to be able to use for their own stores. Whereas if you create a Facebook dark post, then your competitor could come to your website and they're not going to see that post, although you're running advertisement to it, right? And I'm going to show you guys exactly how to get all of that set up. And it's also extremely important, because let's say that you want to create specific posts for segments of your actual, for retargeting, for example, right? Like you want to create a post for people who have added to cart, right? Someone that has added to cart but has not purchased, right? And so you're not going to put up a regular post on your Facebook page that's targeting those people. And so what you do in that case is that you create a Facebook dark post. For example, when you're having specific advertisements for specific products, you're going to create a Facebook dark post. You're not going to spam your Facebook page with every single product that you're going to be advertising. And so obviously there's a lot of value when it comes to the Facebook post, and most of the people out there who are doing very good, they mostly use Facebook posts simply because they don't want anyone coming into their Facebook page and knowing what products they're spending a lot of money on advertisement for, right? So let's get right into it. So I'm going to hop into an empty ad account. What we're going to do is that I'm going to create a campaign here. It's going to be just a conversions campaign. Doesn't matter. I'm going to hit continue, and then I'm going to hit just continue on the ad set. I'm just going to leave it at a default audience right now. And once I get to this area right here, you're going to notice that a Facebook page is already selected here. And then what you guys are going to see right here at the top is that it says create new ad. Okay. Now, when you create an actual Facebook ad from this option here that says create new ad, then you're creating a dark post, okay? And the reason why you're creating a dark post is because when you put that, when you create that advertisement through here, then no one is going to be able to go to your page and see that actual Facebook post, okay? Now, if you want to use a regular post to run advertisement, then you would click right here on use existing post. And then once you click on use existing post, then you're gonna be able to go into your store and actually, or into your Facebook page and pick a certain post from that. Okay, pick a certain post that anyone else could see. So what I recommend that you guys do is that you click on create a new ad and you start releasing your advertisements through here. Now, another strategy for you to be able to do this is to come to the top left hand corner right here. And what you're going to do is that you're going to click on page posts. So right here under the third column, it says page posts. And when you come here, this is another way to create a dark post. When you come to this area right here, you're gonna click on the create post button. And once you click on the create post button, you're gonna select the type of post that you wanna create right here. And at the bottom, it says, how do you wanna use this post? And you're gonna leave it on only use this post for an ad, okay? And now after you click create post and after you create the post through here, then what you're gonna do is that in the middle column of this table down here, there's gonna be a post ID, right? There's gonna be a column that says ID. You guys probably can't see it right now because it's blurred out, but the second column says ID. And what you're going to do is that you're gonna copy that ID, okay? And then when we come back to our Facebook ad manager and we create our campaign, And then we go to conversions, we go to whatever, we select the type of campaign, we select all the data in the actual ad set. Once I'm here, I'm going to click this time use existing post, right? And then I'm going to click on this button right here that says enter post ID, okay? I'm going to click on enter post ID, and then I'm going to paste the actual ID of the post there. And although it says use existing post, I'm still using a dark post because I created it through the page post section right up here, right? And so the reason why I sometimes create it through the page post section is because let's say that I want to go and create another campaign from scratch, like I don't want to duplicate one, then I know the exact post ID of that post, and then I would come here and I would paste it and press submit. Now another way that you guys could enter existing post, like if you want to run another advertisement on an existing post, is that you could go to your Facebook page and you could click on the date of your post. So let's say that I want to run an advertisement from here. I would click on January 5 right here, and you're going to see this URL all the way at the top. This is the actual post ID. Okay, so when you go back to your ads manager, that's where you guys are going to be able to use that number. So remember, if you want to use a dark post, which I suggest that you guys do, you're going to click on create a new ad up here. Or what you're going to do is that you're going to click up here on the top left-hand corner where it says ads manager. You're going to click on page post. And then after you create it in there, then you're going to grab that post ID and you're going to click right here on use existing post. And you're going to click on enter the post ID. All right. So even though you're entering a post ID, because you created it in the other area, it's going to be a dark post. Remember, guys, there's a lot of benefits to that. Remember, guys, I think the benefits far outweigh the cons. I mean, people are not going to be able to know what products you're doing the best with. And so I think it only makes sense that you guys start running your advertisements through Facebook dark posts. And guys, remember, this is a 180-day challenge. If you want to learn more about Facebook ads, about Shopify, about creating your own software and everything like that, make sure you guys tune into my channel. I'm releasing videos daily. Every single week, we're releasing winners to my software and over $1,000 worth of entrepreneurship courses. And all you guys have to do to qualify is subscribe, like this video, and post a comment down below. And every single week, we're going to be choosing one person. I'll see you guys tomorrow on the next video. And if you guys have any other video suggestions like this one, I literally got this video suggestion like 2 days ago, and I'm creating it right now. So if you guys have any videos that you would like to see, make sure that you comment them down below, and I'll go ahead and I'll add them to my list. So I'll see you guys tomorrow.